Hi, and welcome to this introduction to Volcano 3, the latest iteration of FabFilter's creative filter plugin. These days, FabFilter are perhaps best known for their squeaky clean Pro-Q 3 equalizer. But it was in fact their more characterful filter models that first put them on the map, and presumably inspired the company name as well. So when they update all those original filter models over 15 years later, you expect it to be good, right? Fortunately, they don't disappoint. Let's start with three raw sawtooth waves from Twin 2 and run them through a classic-style low-pass filter, which is an updated version of the original Fab filter from FabFilter 1. Let's give this some movement with some Lfo modulation and add some squelchy resonance. We can change the filter slope from a gentle 6 dB per octave up to a steep 48 dB. I'll go with 24 dB this time. The ring around the frequency knob allows us to offset the cutoff for the left and right channels. If I create a new XLFO and drag a connection to this ring, I can add some stereo movement as well. And I'll also add another and use it to modulate the peak knob, so the resonance sweeps up and down automatically. None of this is new so far, but we do now have a drive knob, which is new. It simply changes the gain structure through the filter, so turning it up boosts the input while attenuating the output to compensate, and vice versa. And notice how dramatically this changes the resonance of the filter. Turning it down allows the resonance to whistle freely, almost unaffected by the signal passing through. But turning it up pushes that resonance into saturation and distortion, so it's tamed a little, and starts to interact with the signal being processed. This is the biggest change that's happened under the hood. The non-linear behavior of these filters has been dramatically improved, and pushing them hard now gives deliciously interesting results. But importantly, each of the filter models has different behavior and will react very differently to being pushed hard. Notice how different it sounds when I switch to, say, the hollow style. Or how about raw? Or tube? Okay, different example. This time I'll start with just white noise and run this through three bandpass filters in Volcano 3. Of course, this doesn't make much sense with them running in series, so I'll click the routing button and set them all to run in parallel instead. Now I can turn on the cool inverted keyboard graphic and easily tune these filters to resonate at specific musical notes. Let's have a simple C minor triad. Now I'll add a MIDI modulator and set it to keyboard tracking and modulate the frequency for all three filters. Clicking the pin above a modulator shows depth sliders for all the routings. I'm going to max these all out fully up, but as I've already routed incoming MIDI to the plugin, I can now play this sound from the keyboard and transpose this chord so it follows the changes. I haven't finished with this yet though. If I double click somewhere in the middle, I can add a fourth filter, set up as an EQ style bell. But I don't want this running in parallel with the others, so I'll open the routing window again and set the first three filters to all mix together in parallel and feed filter 4. Let's have some LFO style modulation of the pan ring around filter 4's frequency knob to add some stereo interest. And notice that we still have a drive knob to play with. The bell and shelf filters are just as colourful and non-linear as the low-pass, bandpass and high-pass filters, and vary just as much between the different styles. So I can saturate the first three filters together and get their outputs to intermodulate in interesting ways. Let's talk about these drum sounds, which are each running through a separate instance of Volcano 3. What do they sound like if I bypass all the filters? That's right, it's just noise again. I'm synthesizing all these drum sounds using Volcano's filters with MIDI-triggered envelopes. But of course, half the fun of having synth-style filters in an effect plugin is being able to filter non-synthesizer-type sources. Hands up if you like auto-filter effects on bass guitar. This patch uses an envelope follower set to detect transients to modulate the frequency of a low-pass filter. Or you can use the MIDI modulator plus a MIDI expression pedal to create more traditional wah pedal effects, with a huge range of different flavors available via the different filter models. I bet you didn't know you wanted a tube-powered wah until I just put those words in that order right now. But you can go much further. Being able to run filters in parallel allows you to create more subtle, dare I say, more transparent wah effects that allow more of the sound of your guitar through. You can still tell I'm playing sparkly new strings here, despite the wah effect. Alternatively, running static bandpass filters in parallel can create tube screamer or clon-style overdrive effects. Again, with a huge range of different colours and styles of saturation. But Volcano is also useful after the amplifier. Bracketing and band limiting your guitars with non-linear saturating filters is almost guaranteed to make them sound better. And the same goes for your drum bus, by the way. Try this kind of setting as a magic make your drums sound better trick. Listen to how the sound changes when I toggle bypass. But just as interestingly, here's a level matched comparison with the clean filter style, which is just as linear and free of distortion as the filters in Pro Q3. It's not that there's anything wrong with the clean filters. They're removing low and high frequencies just as they're designed to. But analog filters add some special magic sauce when they're pushed into non-linear territory, and Volcano 3 really nails this behavior. Being a FabFilter plugin, it somehow manages to do this with a very modest CPU load, which only goes up a little bit when you enable oversampling via the high quality button at the bottom. Alternatively, why not set up the filters as low and high shelving bands, with a pair of bell-shaped mid-bands in between, and create a four-band EQ with more colour available than most vintage console emulations. Volcano 3 is quickly becoming as indispensable a part of my mixing workflow as Pro Q3. The delay knobs for each filter are not new, but the new level and pan controls make it much easier to balance the filters when they're running in parallel, allowing for a whole range of lovely flanger or phaser style effects. Of course, there's a comprehensive selection of factory presets to get you started, including some deliciously unexpected surprises. With FabFilter's powerful and comprehensive modulation system to drive it, presets can be step sequencer style, or random, or dynamic driven, or any combination. Speaking of dynamics, you probably didn't expect to find compressor presets in a filter plugin. But you've been listening to this one on the mix bus for the whole video. As usual, there's a comprehensive manual available from the help menu at the top, in case you need more information. Or you can enable pop-up help hints when you hover over a control. That's all for now. Thanks for watching.